Hi everybody and welcome to Noob Gaming. Now offline is finally back online.
May I turn a smile upon you.
And online is still unavailable. I'm not 100% certain when offline or online will be back up, but it does seem like they are currently working on it. At least we can still play the game, which is the most important part, in my opinion, at the moment. But I guess we will take it one step at a time and try to get as far as possible without having any issues.
Cannot do that.
I am really trying to do a type of shield hero build. I'm not sure how far I will be able to get with it before I have to change a different strategy, but I believe it should be possible. They wouldn't have put the skill in the game if it's not. This rebuke doesn't really need any mana to actually be able to cast it, which makes life a little bit easier at least. And it also regenerates mana as well. Mana refunded. Okay. Slow. Length. Your next shield throw can ricochet 5 additional times. Increase stun chance. Bleed stacks. Mana costs more. Increase stun duration. Shield fragments of shield. The shield bash is used while you have a shield. The shield bash is used while the ring of shields is active. The shields form a wall which increases the width of shield bash based on the number of active shields. That's actually quite interesting. We're gonna need to have like 3 in here to get that extra additional slow stack. Okay, so maybe I should go for, when do we get Ring of Shields? That's still quite a far way off. So go from there and there, and then I can get that over there. So 1, 2, 3. Okay. Let's do that.
not do that.
There must be a way to get down there. And seriously, these things are taken to a bigger version of... These things are taken to a smaller version of those.
I cannot do that.
Luckily I'm playing this in softcore, because I don't think this will work all that good with hardcore. Well, not in the beginning. Why am I so slow? It doesn't do enough damage. Something I missed. Armor, stun, bleed, melee physical damage, increased physical damage per strength. Okay. Additional charges. Slow stack, slow duration. Wet area.
Do that.
Okay. Unless I'm not doing too bad playing with this shield type of build.
You are the if you can find that. That's good then. Hurry and find a way in there so we can save the humans.
Yeah, save the humans. Increase cold damage and minion damage, vitality, and void resistance. What does this do? Physical melee area strength. Damage 105, 150. I'll add that in for now. Oh! 6 mana increased cost speed, fire resistance, 2 strength increased mana regeneration, increased health. Okay, that helps. Ah, I thought I didn't say. Down we go. People are complaining about the online. Now, I understand, listen, yes, it's understandable. When you want to play a game, you want to play a game. It's one of those things. It would have been a completely different story if the game was not in early access. I don't understand why people are complaining and are unhappy about the fact that they can't play online or that they can't log in onto the offline services, but people really just need to take a break and think about it. The game is in early access. It's not a very big company that actually is making this game. Games like Path of Exile and Grim Dawn and Diablo have massive teams dedicated for a lot longer than Last Epoch. Now, I understand that it's not the way it should have been due to the whole reason of everybody wants to. They had this big announcement, you know, 9 March, multiplayer is finally going to be released and all that, but come on, be real. It's an early access game. Multi-strike, we need now. Retribution. So yeah. So people just need to realize there will be bugs, there will be cases where the game will crash it's all part of early access. This is the reason why they have a forum on their page. If you go to Last Epoch, you can physically physically put in any errors or bugs or crashes that you get inside of the game. And this will help the developers to actually just go ahead and fix the problems instead of just using the forum to complain about every single last detail. Shields. Tell me, has anybody else ever tried a complete shield build?
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
Skills in the right sequence, I should be able to do a lot more damage.
I cannot do that.
That was a big mistake. My shield bash has increased. Level. That's what I will get once I get shield throw. Damage versus full health enemies. Final void hit. Okay, I actually just wanted that. No longer requires a shield. Shield crush hits deals additional void damage, but this damage is reduced by your increased attack speed. Voidbreaker Shield Rush finally hits and deals additional melee void damage. I really want to do void. Hit area. Okay, Fallen Heat Strike twice. Fallen Heat Echo Base Critical Chance. Fallen Heat Echo Critical. I think I'm gonna go for this Fallen Heat Damage. And then right off the back over there. That increases my damage. And this increases my Fallen Heat area. So I'm thinking of increasing my final heat area, and then from there onwards I will go to my damage and my damage per point of year. No cooldown, no guard. Yeah. This, I'm still contemplating on how to work with it. That final hit area is that shockwave that is underneath you. I presume.
I cannot do that.
Do not die. Vitality, resistance, increased armor. I'll gain on block. Purchase, and we will call this our idle stash. Idle, and then we will make it this little signage right over there, and we will make it the color blue. Confirm. Okay, and then we will chuck this into there for now. don't have any legendaries. How's that possible?
Greetings.
I'll do it. Multi-strike thing. I wanted to see what that is about. Oh, that's just a normal attack. Flip a green up. How is it? Yeah. Would have thought multi-strike would have been like an aura or something, you know? Cooldown, recovery speed 1. Don't increase health regen. I can't put it up because it requires level 16. And I'm not level 16 yet. A little bit under leveled. Let's see with how much. Oh, just one level, it's not that bad. Taking a look at my cooldown periods. No, I am not taking a look at it. Good. Health gain per point. You gain health and mana when you directly use Rive. I'm not using it. Smite on multi-strike. Not need either one of those things. So that doesn't really help. It actually does help to actually read what it says. Health gained on block. That can help. Oh yeah. And in we go. One Smash really does not do a lot of damage.
I cannot do that.
So... Time to get the banner.
Who are you?
Alright, I already get it. Yeah, something like that. You saved us a while! This area is going to be a little bit more tricky and a little bit more difficult with the shield, the skills that I currently have. Through all the small fry and then concentrate only on the big eye. Okay, let's see. 148, 102, 143. Shield rush. It's damage. That's final hit area. That's mana efficiency. Damage taken while rushing. Increased stun chance. That's actually also a fairly good thing to do. Increased cool damage, mana regeneration, fire resistance, and poison resistance. Yeah. 17 points. Mana shard. No. No! Physical damage, poison damage, increase health regeneration. Restore some mana regeneration. I want the mana regeneration. Increased stun chance 12%, void vengeance, increased melee damage, half regen. Origin, fire damage, torturing, poison resistance. Magic Cliff of Chaos. Not really going to go into poison of chaos damage. We go more into play with my Titan character. My prime list that I have on online. I'd love to play with that. See how the whole Titan thing works, but I'm not gonna push my luck at the moment. So length is 10%, so that's increased length. I'm going all over the place. Okay, shield bash after shield rush. After you use shield rush or lunge, you shield bash in the direction you traveled. Shield bash must have a cooldown, be charged, and on your action. Or for this effect to work. Okay, that's actually pretty interesting. That is actually very interesting. So if I take that away, I'll remember that. That's actually quite an interesting turn of events. Wondered if you were able to take that out before you talk to this quest giver, but it doesn't look like it, eh? Really does not look like it. Lost Imperial. I'll be back. Poison. Oh, lovely. Oh, forge. 18 forge potential. It's not a lot. But this is area, strength, melee, and physical. So, technically speaking, if we can get this shield up on melee, modifies the outcome, 25% chance to have no forging put there. Okay. Armor, block chance, block efficiency, cold resistance, health. Lightning, void damage taken on block, adds reduced damage taken. Physical resistance. That's any affix. Let's go to the prefix. Block on chance and block efficiency, that's all I have. Armor, core resistance, health, lightning, resistance, void damage taken on block, and physical resistance. It's not a lot. No fire? Add a random tier 1 affix to all empty FX slots on any item has an increased chance of rolling a rare FX. Okay. That is fine. Damage reflect on attack, health gain on block, void resistance and chance to shock attackers. That is not too bad, and I still have my full chance slow on it. Let's see. Lot more out of this.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
Okay. That's one down, at least. Health potion.
Stand down.
It is taking me a little bit longer. Taking me a little bit. Void cleave requires a two-handed sword or axe. Is that new? I do not remember that skill. No, honestly, I really do not remember that. Where's that javelin? Increased damage. Okay. Look like a champion. Go for legs. Additional javelins. Three javelins rain down. Bleed chance. Damage over time. Piercing lightning spears when it costs. Javelin no longer pierce. So lightning damage. Base damage. Electrify. It's actually quite interesting. Electrify. That gives me also an idea for a bold. Fire and lightning damage drone. I've seen that actually before. Yeah, well, let's continue. Reminds me a lot. This javelin throw actually reminds me a lot of the, what's that thing? Pierce arrow or puncture for the ranger build.
Cannot do that.
really does remind me a lot of the puncture. Just one single strike. Slightly got lazy with this. Just my personal opinion. If you don't like that opinion, it's fine by me. It's an interesting concept for a melee character, but it's kinda copy and paste. It looks also almost the same if you think about it. Right there. It really does almost look the same. It's just the animation is a bit different. And a little bit of a change in color. That is what I love about this. It's an excellent movement skill.
Yes.
And we free them. And there they are. Now I need to use this. No. I'm gonna try and complete this with just... Extremely close. That's not easy. That is not easy. Thinking of how I'm going to do this. So instead of this wins the race. Or just take it from the bar. Thank you.
mean?
I don't know if I'm going to be able to re-speak all my skills. I'm only unlocked at level 20, re-chairman. That's 19. Yeah. Lunge. Hammer throw. This truck is also not really going to work. That's the one thing that does the most damage. So maybe I should just try and concentrate on shield rush? See if that works. Run around in circles. Clearly, the whole Nafumi thing was not going to work out. So, respect the specialization. I got 3 points. Okay. We'll put it into javelin. And then bleach arms. Make sure I'm gonna go lightning. Yeah, I'll specialize in here. Okay, this is ignite, that's fire, okay? That's bleed chance, slow chance. Max bonus heat damage. Attack speed, damage plus attack speed. Next melee attack costs. So maybe one there. There, and there, and then I'll knock that one right over there, and then from there I'll go into here for now. That's the only thing that I can think of at the moment. Hopefully this works, because I'm kind of out of ideas, but I'm gonna need to get... Lunge in here for now. Fairly far away from actually leveling. Okay. Counselor of Chambers. Costs more mana. This is frustrating.
Hey there, want to try your luck?
Gamble. Pike. Magic item.
Maybe it'll help you along the way.
Increase damage over time, chance to bleed on hit. Wait a minute. 13. Now, it's currently doing throwing, attack, area, and strength. Now, I don't have any runes. Chance to ignite, I can add in, and then add FX, and then... prefix. Melee strike, lightning damage. Add it. Tier 1, tier 2, yeah. Oh, forge. Inventory, that's 144, so let's take that off. That doesn't change anything, but that does.
You feeling lucky?
Gamble. Skill. Okay. We're gonna need to go a different route. Respec. Despecialize. And then we are going to go for rebuke. So that actually does help with. Yeah, I think we're gonna go with rebuke. Duration, hit damage, area points, void. Block abilities, it's just not really requires points in Sentinel base passive. Let's see how this works. hoping this works better. Because I'm really at this moment out of our ideas. Really wanted to go for the whole Sentinel build, shield build. I can still respec maybe a little bit later, but at this moment it's not going to work. So let's just change that and that around. Yeah, that's not even going to work anymore. So... multi strike?
Yes?
More damage. This is actually going a lot faster now. Fortunately, I had to change the build. I had no other choice. Still want to see how that looks like, but we'll get there. It's frustrating if a person has to change their build midway. I haven't even selected my class yet. Speaking, it's not piercing actually anymore because it's not. Interesting. Just got an interesting idea. technically two-handed. Hey, next level I'm getting that other ability. I really want to see how it looks like. Really close to it anyway as well. Fairly accurate. That's like only probably takes a lot of mana. And sword. Fine. Oh, I lose a lot of... Let's see. Increased cooldown. Increased cooldown recovery speed 10%. So maybe it takes longer. Shorter. Let's see cooldown. So there, and cooldown has travel skills. It's not that much of a cooldown. Time rot. Battling for a void cleaves hits at least one enemy, your next throwing attack inflicts time rot. There's actually nothing void in this. Strange. So that will fall under the void. Shield throw, manifest armor, ring of shields, smelter's wrath, channel the charge, a powerful frontal cone attack dealing fire and physical damage to all enemies, charging for longer, increase the range of power, seconds to maximum, forge strike. Summons a forged weapon which lasts 20 seconds. Yeah, I'll take back what I once said. Healing hand. Holy aura. I'm gonna have to take that away. Weakly deals melee damage. Max distance, area. After channeling, warp off for at least 2 seconds. Your next void cleave within 1 second. Oh, does that work? Void cleave hits ignite. of the channeling warpath. Oh, warpath is the... Okay. Oh, warpath, you can go... Void. I wonder if I should just change everything to... Yeah, why not? Despecialize. Let's chuck Warpath in there. That's almost anyway. Area 15% melee. Okay. Let's see. That's on 18. Retributions, multi-strike, vengeance, smite. Lightning damage. Let's see. Still looks the same. I think as for that, I'm gonna need to be able to... Okay, so let's put Warpath right there. And then we're gonna put... Rebuke right there, Cleave there, Lunge here, and... Let's go with Hammer Throw, maybe? Remove this, respect, despecialize. We add in Void Cleave. Damage area cooldown. So there, there, and there. I could have actually gone there as well. But these 2 seconds, your next Void Cleave with 1 second deals more damage. Onto that Void Resistance. That as well, actually. Abyssal Echoes of the Void Cleave. Okay. Actually, I think I do remember Void Cleave now. Devouring Orb, Volatile, Abyssal Echoes, Forging Strike, Shield Throw, Traveling doesn't really fit in into any of these. The vine bolt, whenever you hit an enemy with a melee attack, you have a chance to hit the vine bolt. Yeah. Not certain. I must say, if I think of Javelin, and if I go 1-1, Divine Prowess Javelin has physical damage converted to lightning. Consequently, this damage scales with increased lightning damage, but not increased physical damage. So... melee physical, retribution, that doesn't help. Resistances, increased damage. Damage taken, increased cooldown. Can equip, axe thrown. Lightning? It's just... oh, paladin. Increased lightning damage. So yes, blind charms, holy presence, critical multiplier, lightning strikes, increased fire damage, lightning damage. That would be the best bet to go with this. So maybe, just maybe. Yeah, respec, specialize. Take Javelin again. Sorry guys, I'm changing my mind a lot at the moment. But I'm thinking of how this will work for the beast. Javelin right there. Switch back to the Javelin. Remove cleave, but I really do not need cleave. Then I remove that. And we'll add in rebuke. If we're gonna go paladin, then I would say Infinite card because an increased regeneration shell duration element lingering fire. Let's see, no lightning really. Mana regen, heal amount, increased healing, acceleration, healing regen, armor, elemental damage taken, buffs. Mana regen, yield amount. Yeah, so let's go into 1, 2, 3. We'll get the yield amount, increase healing per point, and healing increase. I'm thinking of going that way. Okay, let's try this again. Thank you.
34.
So it makes a lot more sense to have a pike or a spear when you use javelin. Clearing distance is quite phenomenal. I do like the whole clearing distance. Yeah, I remember I picked up a lightning resistance. The current rule, this is giving me margin fire damage. This gives me elemental. Attack a lot more precisely with this. Okay, nobody's online anymore. How wonderful. be thinking of taking that out. It's physical damage. Can remove a couple of points there. Now I've got smite. Yay, smite! Just check something with smite. Nope, I'm not too bothered about that. Smite is really going to help with this. Please rebuke. Maybe lunge. Nope. Chaplain, rebuke. That's also a constant hit. I don't know what's going to be my next ability. That's not going to help. I guess let's go for a whirlwind for now, or warpath. Just for now, because it doesn't really help to choose anything at this moment. Okay. This is basically literally just to be able to something else. Because if they do get close to me, I've got a war pause. Which I then can use to mow down my enemies. But I don't think that's going to be needed actually, in all honesty. Thought it was going to be needed, that then it was. It's not really good for single target. Melee fire damage. I can't even take that as fire. Oh, you can actually. Ignite. Holism. Oh, I have another idea. Respect. You synchronize skill boot. Reeve in there. Specialize. I'm gonna go for. That's area damage. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just wanted that. So. Inventory, transfer, spec. That there. Put cleave over there and put lunge over there. So what's my damage? 183. 221. 234. 190. That's a bit better. Okay. Interesting. I think I was wrong, it's still gonna change my mind a couple of times. Sense that it would be stronger. To respect these things. Okay, so I'm gonna put Cleave over there. I'm gonna put Lunge. We're gonna put on R. Lunge, we're going to put on R. Rebuke, we're gonna put down there. We're both. Area 15% bigger. Beachons. Melee fire damage to ignite. Global spell damage. Healing inside area. Smite chance. Okay, so area. Let's see. Area. No. Not respect. Area. Just area. Area per second spinning 15% per point. After spinning for at least 2 seconds, you do war slash. At the end, this deals more damage. For each second you continue to spin, Warcraft deals more damage. Multiple things with other modifiers in a larger area, but cost more mana. Area, that's like 20%. It's a little bit of fire damage, not really a lot. Forge, master, stance, summoner forged, weapon while spinning. Chamber cost. That's stupid. Two-handed, that's dual wielding. Okay. Let's see. Dang it. Okay. Because I did not pre-plan everything accordingly as I should have. Rebuke.
Great battle was lost here. Darkness is all that is left.
Yep. Where was it going to?
This place has seen so much.
see this still fucking in the bar, almost.
Stand down, or die.
Just get rid of my thing, so. Almost. Technically a two-handed weapon. Okay, 277. This will increase it to 393. Damn! That helps a lot. More cold resistance. Okay, let's see. A little bit better, at least. Fire 26 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 16 On that area of wood. And then I'm going to here. Two in there. One there. Two there. Global melee health, leech of X 2%, global critical loss, bring even additional melee leech while wielding X, additional base critical chance. So many things that I want. Well, I guess I can't have everything. That does a lot of damage. I'll be back, give me a couple of minutes. Okay, and I am back.
Thank you.
Let's see. That will be good for the rogue. And to remember to put that in the stash.
May it tear a smile upon you. Farewell. Greetings. Do not dwell
yes.
on regret.
Feet. Yes. Follow your feet.
You may find a treasure, my friend.
One-handed axe. I would have thought that would have been a two-handed. Okay. These people that were able to complete this, like within half an hour, to get to this point. I really no idea how they are able to do that. Years and years of experience. Or not just years of experience, just. Well, professionals. What the? Stretch. Okay. Nice.
seem a little disoriented.
Don't act so...
This is what is like when you... Whenever a time... Most of them, he might be kind enough to stay safe.
So I think when... I'm not actually doing the whole shit. Javelin thing. This area looks more or less the same than the previous version. Just the...
You've woken up. I see your countless
This is
close your eyes and focus on the potential.
Okay, this is horrible.
As I guide
the previous version, you,
to you
were able to actually, you know, go through a whole traveling section to get to it where that, where you had the statues. And this now you just select. Yeah, I really don't like that idea, but oh well. Bulwark, strength in steel, which mastery of weapons and armor and animation, molten metal. I'm gonna go for forge. Now that is a ability.
I see. I believe many centuries they were. We be the seek out the outcast queen, leader of the living rebels, and show her the epoch. The rest will be up to you.
I'm gonna stick with rebuke. This thing saves. Helps a lot. It really does. Duration. Increase the duration. But yeah. Before I forget. Okay, block efficiency, increase throwing attack. Okay, so this would have actually worked with physical resistances. Let's see, fire. Physical resistance, strength, increase throwing attack. I'm not really doing throwing. So, I think we're gonna go with resistances then. I'm gonna need to go for this. Strength. Increase melee attack, physical damage. Yet again. I should have went with Paladin. Physical resistances. Increase throwing attack. Next melee attack, physical damage. Throwing attack, mana cost 6 per point. That's a lot. Ignite. Stun resistances. Fire damage taken on block. Increased fire damage over time. Yeah, looking like I'm gonna need to respec again. Okay, let's re-spec again.
I cannot do that.
Okay, that's just like right in front of you. It's a lot of damage there.
Yes. Stay safe.
I see. What do you want?
So let's see something. That shield for her. Okay, that's what I actually wanted to go with. For this whole Nafumi build that I was thinking of. That's Javelin. Javelin's got fire as well, doesn't it? But this whole thing doesn't really have fire. Max bonus, physical. Increase throwing attack, increase melee damage. Physical damage. But, wait. Increase melee damage, it's 12%. Wait. I'm not going to have to I'm gonna respect that point. That's for certain. Because if I go back here and I go into where is it? This will go with melee damage, and Reeve, physical damage increases fire damage, so I'm fine. Don't even need a shield to do that. That's weird. Okay, I think we'll see how far we can get to the. We can kill the great bones quickly. Now I get a shield. Block charms, gang charge, soul charge on kill. It's the feast. That's more for the. Now I'm getting all the percent of current health lost per second, 20% of missing health gained as ward per second, 22 increased attack speed, cast speed, and movement speed if you have used a potion within the last war. Immunity to bleed. That is not really that great of a ability. Look at that. Why? Why would any... No. Why would anybody wear that?
Dinos might be your best bet.
Anyway, thanks for watching everybody. Please like and follow and comment. It would really mean a lot. Thank you for watching, and we will be doing this again shortly. Have a wonderful night.